It's been well over a month now that students have been out of school. And for some, being ripped from their routine is incredibly challenging. And what about students with special needs? Does all of this affect them differently? Sarah Edwards is in Salisbury and she has a daughter with special needs. Sarah, how you doing?
Great, how are you doing?
Good, she's gonna join us today to talk a little bit about that. So first of all, tell us about your daughter.
Oh, Madison. I have a beautiful little spunky 12-year-old. She goes to Pemberton, involved in cheer and everything in between, and she's just a pretty cool kid.
Yeah, I bet. She already sounds cool. So does this, what's going on, impact her differently?
You know, it's funny you ask that. I have a 9-year-old daughter, too, and I look at both of them trying to keep that answer that question myself, but honestly, they're both being impacted the same way. Mm-hmm. They both miss their friends, just like you and I do, probably. We miss being around people. And it's hard. It's hard being stuck.
Yeah.
They've been stuck for over a month.
So then, you know, when asking that question about, you know, children with special needs, it probably is different for everybody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it depends on the diagnosis. It depends on the personality, whether an introvert or extrovert. And I would say it depends on the medical situation too, but there's so many diagnoses and different needs. I think it's hard on the children. It's also hard on the caregivers.
Sure. So before all this happened, you were in the middle of launching a special needs ministry at Emmanuel Wesleyan Church.
Yes, we were. Very exciting.
Yeah. So tell me just a little bit about, you know, what inspired that.
My heart has been, had a calling for this for some time and just had the perfect opportunity. I had the wonderful support of Mark Bunting and the church to really reach out and start building what I would say is meeting the needs of Salisbury, and that's what Emmanuel does. We just go out and we want to make impact. We have about 15% of our population that has special needs, and so with that, we have about 1,800, just over 1,800 kids that have IEPs, and over 15,000 people in our local community that have some form of special need. And we just wanted to have a place of worship for them and a place where parents could have respite and a place that was safe and sensory friendly and inviting and welcoming so that everyone has the opportunity to receive the message.
So how far did you get in kind of building this ministry before, you know, the coronavirus kind of hit?
We literally just got started with the designing of the space, and we had an interest meeting at the church. So we had a lovely outpouring of support of volunteers. We are just in a space now where we're trying to raise the money to build out that space and get it underway. Our goal is to have that thing built and ready as soon as this coronavirus thing goes away so that we can all come back together and have community.
Yeah, and so, and kind of even further than that, like, you must have big goals for this whole ministry in general.
I think anyone that knows me knows that I do dream big. And, you know, I do have big goals and dreams. I think that we have a lot of opportunity to make a huge impact in our community. But I think starting small is just getting this space built and having a place to come. And from there, building off that foundation.
Definitely. So, you know, you were kind of saying, you kind of just said how much Salisbury is impacted, you know, by special needs in general. So if somebody's wanting to get involved with this or help support it, like, what can they do?
I think the best thing to do is if they want to be a volunteer or they can benefit by being a part of this ministry and receiving the benefits of the ministry or supporting it in other ways, is sending an email, and I believe you can provide that email, and then we can get you in touch with the right contacts and get going forward.
Yeah, and of course, we'll have all that information on our website. Sarah, thank you so much for taking the time out today to talk with us.
We appreciate the opportunity.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Can't wait for, you know, after this and to watch the ministry grow.
Thank you so much. Well, you have a wonderful day.
You too.